Hey everyone, Tim here, back again for Droid Life. Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today we are looking at the all new, well, not necessarily all new, but we are taking a look at the LG Watch W7, their hybrid mechanical smartwatch. This device was announced alongside the LG V40 and then quietly went on sale on Best Buy's website for $450. If you were around for Black Friday, you'll know that it was down to $250 for actually a couple of weeks, and we're like, okay, $250, not a bad buy, I guess, but it's back up to $450. So we finally have one in the house, so we're just going to go ahead, dive right in. This is going to be an overview. We'll talk a bit about the specs and really kind of show you how these mechanical hands and Wear OS kind of pair together and the experience that LG is offering here for $450. So we'll dive right in for the specs first. So inside, Snapdragon Wear 2100 processor, not the 3100. We'll actually get more into that here in a little bit. A 1.2-inch full-circle LCD display, 360 by 360. That's 300 PPI for those curious and those who need to know. But of course, you'll know that right there in the middle where the mechanical hands come out, there is no display there, technically, where that hole is. So full circle, but I guess if you want to call it like a notch or like a punch hole is right in the middle there for those mechanical hands. So of course, any watch face you use that has, you know, digital hands or anything like that isn't going to look so great because you have these mechanical hands. So moving along, 4 gigs of RAM, 768 megabytes of RAM, a somewhat small 240 milliamp hour battery, Wi-Fi connectivity, of course, Bluetooth 4.2, low energy. Does come with a Pogo charger there on the back. It's not magnetic at all. You just stick it on there and it will charge the smartwatch. Of course, water and dust resistance, got an accelerometer, gyro, pressure, compass, altimeter, barometer, and all that works into these mechanical hands. And I'll give you a demo of that here in a little bit. Band size 22 millimeter for all you. I'm pretty sure it's 22 millimeter. The straps I use for my Seiko 007 work just fine, and I'm pretty sure those are 22 millimeter. So if you want to change out this rubber band, this rubber strap, you can throw on like a NATO strap or a nice leather strap, whatever you want to do. The watch itself, not too thick. You know, somewhat close to the LG Watch Sport, I believe that was from a couple of years ago. Not as thick, though. Actually looks pretty good. I have somewhat small wrists, and it doesn't look all that bad. The crown, while it may look like it's kind of digging in, doesn't feel that bad at all. I'm pretty used to wearing a watch, so not bad. I'm just going to call it the digital crown just because I know that's sort of like Apple's thing, but dang it, that's what it is. So you've got your power button here, your little app launcher button, of course, to get into the apps. And then two dedicated hardware buttons that you can program to do certain things on the watch. So always fun. Moving on here, let's see. Whoops, go back. So wanted to quickly discuss why this watch does have the 2100, not the 3100. LG was pretty adamant that the 3100, basically the only difference between 2100 and 3100 is the 3100's co-processor for that ambient mode and maybe like dedicated sports experiences. However, what this watch is not featuring pretty much means that you don't need the 3100. There is no NFC, so no mobile payments. There is no standalone GPS, so you don't need the dedicated sports stuff. And with the traditional watch mode, which is exactly what you're seeing here, the blacked out screen with just the mechanical hands, you don't need the ambient mode. So with this, LG says if it looks just like this, black dial, black face, you can last about 100 days of battery life on that 240 milliamp hour battery. So not bad at all, but... You know, if you're only going to be using the watch like this for 100 days, I gotta say, I mean, it's not the prettiest looking thing in the world. However, you know, because it is a hybrid, you can do a little bit of both. You know, no one's saying you have to go watch only mode or anything like that. So you can switch back and forth if you want sort of that smart experience versus going through the watch only mode and like a full-blown smart watch, which is totally fine. Get your notifications, etc. So let's dive in. See what this watch all can do with the mechanical hands. And I don't know if anyone's played with the new Wear OS. This is basically my first first run with it here in a while. So, of course, you have your regular watch face here, and LG built in a ton of different watch faces. You access them the same way you always have. You can go in here. Of course, you can go into the Android or the Wear OS app itself and sort of customize these faces, see all the different ones. But you can just scroll through the different faces, markers, complications. There's a lot of different styles on here. LG obviously spared no expense working with a few partners here to get the most out of these watch faces that go well with the mechanical hands. So that's that. If we swipe to the right here, you can access your Google Assistant, weather, directions, home. I didn't know they were doing this, but they have a quote of the day now. Interesting, this one's from Seneca. Swiping to the right, you get to Google Fit. Swiping down, you get to these notifications. And then swiping down, you get your system toggles, brightness, watch only mode, do not disturb, airplane mode, etc. And then, of course, you can get to all your settings. And then you can, of course, navigate via the what I'm calling the digital crown. So all good. Fine and dandy. Now, one thing, of course, the first thing people say is, oh man, what happens when notifications come in? Well, let's say, for example, I've got this notification right here. I can't see it all too well. With the top right button that comes out of the box, if you long press on that, it'll move the hands out of the way, and so I can read that, oh, PSD Underwear says my package is on the way, thank God. I got some Black Friday deals from them, solid deal. So that's with anything. So whatever is in the middle of the display is going to be pushed to the top. The entire UI, as you'll see, gets pushed to the top, and the hands are taken out of the way. Now, depending on what time it is where the hands will go. So let's say it's 10:57. The hands are going to go over to the 9 o'clock position. As you can see, if it's 12:10, the hands are going to go over to the 3 o'clock position, and that whole UI gets brought up. That way, you can see what's in the middle of the display. When you're wearing the watch and doing that, you know it's not the worst thing ever. However, you can, so say you're holding it like this, you can long press that and then still scroll and sort of access the UI or scroll through notifications. It's just not the most intuitive thing I've ever seen. I'm still kind of getting used to this whole idea of having mechanical hands. This is my first experience with a real Wear OS hybrid smartwatch. So still getting used to it. It's definitely funky, but I will say it's not the worst thing ever. Maybe if you see it in pictures, you're like, oh my god, what was LG thinking? But it's not nearly that bad. So quick, let's show what these mechanical hands can do, because they can do some cool stuff. So if you open up the apps here, of course, you can get through your different apps by swiping, doing all that. This top portion up here is not clickable, which is unfortunate. But if we go into here into the master tools, click on that, you'll see that the watch is capable of a compass, stopwatch, timer. Oh my lord. Barometer, altimeter, and then of course calibration. So let's say we want to do a compass. This is actually pretty cool. So I've already calibrated the device. It knows that north is over in that direction. But so depending on however I tilt the watch, you'll see the mechanical hand will actually move as the dial facing north. Very nice little touch, I must say. It looks cool in person at least. And then a stopwatch, again, a very nice little, you got your start button. It's going to go, and then it'll click around. Naturally, you're going to lose time-telling function as you're using features like this, but it looks cool. You know, what can I say? I'm a sucker for things that look cool. Same thing with the altimeter. As long as you sync up your location data with Wear OS on this device, it'll show you, hey, I am 25 meters above sea level here in Portland, Oregon. Fantastic. As you get, higher up, it's going to move the dial. Of course, small points of a meter isn't going to show much, but something that it can do. So I think it's a very nice touch. You know, LG sort of tried to build in special features that could benefit from the mechanical hands, and you know, as more of a timepiece fan, not really a smartwatch guy, it's a decent attempt. And so another thing, with regards to the 2100 and 3100, LG mentions that they've been working on this device for almost 3 years. And so they didn't want to change many of the components so far along into it. I mean, the 3100 was announced not too long ago. So really, there just wasn't enough time for LG to change it out from the 2100 to the 3100. And really, as I mentioned, you aren't going to be getting too many benefits from the 3100, at least on this device in particular. So a lot of cool stuff. If you're a big fan of sort of your traditional timepiece, it's a decent hybrid, maybe into the world of smart devices. Again, you can turn it off. You're just going to get that all black dial. Not the most exhilarating thing to look at. You could get a, for $450, you could get like a automatic Hamilton or even $200 an automatic Seiko, and you're going to be happy with those timepieces. This, of course, you know, it does a lot more. It's going to be showing you your emails, your Twitters, all your good stuff. And the only problem is no heart rate monitor, no standalone GPS, no NFC. So you are missing quite a bit. It's somewhat of a compromise. But of course, you know, if you get a regular old watch, there's no smarts at all, no NFC on those. So it's really up to the buyer. It comes only in this cloud silver color, again, for $450. I'm going to be using this watch over the weekend and next week, and I'll be sure to have a full review up in no time at all. And until then, if you guys have any questions, comments, feel free to throw them down in below, and I will try and get them answered for you. And that's the LG Watch W7. We're Droid Life. Peace.